In this video, we will discuss the next mode of asexual reproduction, that is the asexual mode of reproduction in plants named as vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation occurs only in plants. It is a mode of asexual reproduction in which the old plant, say the parent plant, will give rise to certain reproductive units known as vegetative propagules. And those vegetative propagules have the capacity to give rise to a young plant, to give rise to a new individual without the formation of seeds. That is known as vegetative propagation. What happens in the vegetative propagation, bache? The vegetative propagule has buds over it, and buds are present in dormant state. What is dormant state? The inactive state is referred as dormant state, in which the parts do not die, bache. They will remain inactive for certain fixed interval of time. In favorable conditions, whensoever the favorable conditions will be there, those buds will give rise to a young plant, and that is known as vegetative propagation. The plant parts can be grown into a young one. For example, bache, the plants which can be grown by leaves, bryophyllum and begonia. Do learn these examples carefully, as these are very important for your board exam, bache. By roots, asparagus is known as alsi in Hindi, bache. Mint, sweet potato. These are certain plants whose roots can give rise to, or will give rise to, a young one, will give rise to a new plant. Next, by stems, green grasses, potato, onion. These are the plants in which the stem part, which has reproductive buds. The only condition necessary for a plant part to be a vegetative propagule is that it must possess the reproductive bud. बच्चे प्लांट में तो बहुत सारे पार्ट्स हैं बेटा, एक स्टेम तो बहुत बड़ी है, कैसे पता चलेगा कि वो एक यंग वन को प्रोड्यूस कर पाएगी या नहीं? अगर उस पार्ट पर रिप्रोडक्टिव बड्स हैं, तभी वो एक वेजिटेटिव प्रोपग्यूल है, अदरवाइज नहीं. सो व्हाट इज द नेसेसरी कंडीशन फॉर अ पार्ट टू बी अ वेजिटेटिव प्रोपग्यूल? दैट इट मस्ट पोजेस द रिप्रोडक्टिव बड्स ओवर इट, ओनली देन दैट पार्ट विल गिव राइज टू अ यंग वन. द यू नो प्लांट्स व्हिच ग्रोज बाय stem, sugar cane as well. This is a very important example. You must have seen the potato, bache. The potato has certain eyes over it. Those eyes will give rise to a small thread-like structures known as tubers. And from those tubers, a young plant of potato is regenerated, is produced, and that is known as vegetative propagation. This mode of reproduction is known as vegetative propagation in plants. Now we will discuss the artificial method of vegetative propagation. The method of growing plants from a parent plant by man-made methods is known as artificial vegetative propagation. Simply, bache, it is a form of vegetative propagation in which human involvement is there. It is a mode of reproduction in plants in which a plant part will give rise to young ones by human involvement, by human made methods, that is known as artificial vegetative propagation. These methods are used extensively, exclusively in agriculture, that is the growth of crop plants, as well as in the horticulture, that is the cultivation and the growth of vegetables. The three methods which you will discuss in detail. The first one is cutting, and grafting. Out of these three, the grafting is in your 10th class syllabus. The first one is cutting. Cutting is a matter, bache, in which a plant part which has reproductive bud. That is, suppose I cut a stem, bache. This stem must possess a bud over it. This is the bud. This is the stem. This bud will give rise to a young plant. From here, roots will regenerate, beta, and this bud will give rise to a young plant. So in this, we cut the part which has the reproductive buds over it, and then, you know, we grow that part in a separate place. This method of vegetative propagation is known as artificial vegetative propagation, as humans doing the cutting. And we are cutting the part which has, you know, reproductive buds or vegetative propagules, that is known as cutting. Second, bache, layering. In this, the part of the plant which has reproductive buds over it is bent over and then digged into the soil. Like this, this part originally is straight, bache, but the part which has reproductive bud over it is placed into the soil, and then mounting of, you know, sawdust or, you know, fertile soil is done over it. Mounting means to a tila bana de, so that the nutrients availability to that particular part will be enriched. After some time, that part will grow a young plant. We cut it from the parent plant. So now these plants are two. So this method is known as layering. The method in which we, you know, dig the plant part which has reproductive bud into it in the neighborhood, and that part will grow into a young one. That method is known as layering. Us method ko kya bolte hain bache? Layering. By layering and the cutting, certain, you know, plants which grows, the example of cutting are sugar cane, next rose, chrysanthemum. These plants are grown by cutting. The examples of layering are guava, jasmine. Jasmine can be grown by cutting as well. So these are certain examples of cutting and layering. In this video, we will discuss the third artificial propagation method, that is grafting. What is grafting, bache? It is a method in which the two parts of a plant, one possessing the roots and the other without the roots, is joined together. The part which possesses the roots is known as a stalk, and the parts without roots is known as a scion. So the part of the graft which has roots with it is known as a stalk, and the part of the graft which has a scion, which do not have the roots, is known as a scion. One more thing we have to keep in mind, that scion is from a young plant which is yet to be mature, and stalk must be taken from a mature plant which is already matured. That would be, you know, one of the best methods of grafting. So it is the method in which we join the two parts of a plant, one possessing the roots and other one without roots. The parts which is without roots is placed over the stalk. One condition necessary for grafting is that the only plants which can perform or which can undergo this, those plants must possess vascular cambium. So in monocotyledons, grafting is not possible. It is only possible in dicotyledons plants, because they possess vascular cambium. then these two parts join together. And muslin cloth is wrapped over it with some sawdust or cow dung to provide them nutrition. So that is the combination. What is the benefit of it? What is the advantage, bache? This young scion, which is yet too mature, will give the fruit early on. So it is the benefit of grafting. Next benefit is, we can combine two or more than two desirable traits in one variety. The plant which grows by this method, bache, possess the best quality, possess the good qualities of both these different plants. So that is known as combination of, you know, desirable traits, desirable characters. Second, the development of seedless fruit variety can be developed by grafting. By this grafting, we can be able to, you know, redevelop the seedless grapes which do not possess much seeds. So that is the advantage of grafting. Third advantage is early maturation. By grafting, the young scion, which will otherwise take time, will grow early and mature early and give rise to the fruit before its proper age. So that would be beneficial for us. We will get the plants more in number, sorry, we get the fruits more in number as well as earlier than its usual life. So that is the grafting technique, and these are the advantages of grafting. Now we will discuss advantages of vegetative propagation. What are the advantages, what are the benefits of vegetative propagation? The first one is early maturation. By vegetative propagation methods like grafting, we bring about the early maturation in certain plants, which gives us the fruit earlier in their particular age. So that is the advantage of artificial or vegetative propagation. Second, seedless varieties. By artificial vegetative propagation, we can grow the varieties without seeds. The seedless varieties can be redeveloped or developed by artificial vegetative propagation method. Next, genetic uniformity. As clones are produced in asexual method or in vegetative propagation, so genetic uniformity, the uniqueness of a gene complex, you know, gene concept is maintained. The total genes will remain same throughout the production of species. So that genetic uniformity is maintained. Next, what change? Survival rate. The survival rate of vegetative propagation method or asexual method in plants is almost 100%. Whereas, if we grow the plants, if we produce the plants by usual sexual reproduction method by seeds, then the growth rate is only 1 to 10%. So the next advantage is survival rate. The next one is the pure line is maintained. Pure line means, if suppose we have a very good variety of crop with us, we want to produce those plants only again and again, then asexual method to grow that plant is most appropriate, as there is no change in the DNA sequence, there is no change in the characters. That means that particular plant, that particular property of the plant will remain, regrow again and again, will again produce multiple times. So that is to be maintained by vegetative propagation. And these are the advantages of vegetative propagation.